Good afternoon, everyone. I'm quite nervous since I haven't been talked on tech conference for nearly 2 years, and I'm super happy that I get this opportunity to bring my side project to a tech conference, even though the content of my presentation won't be attached to any tech or game related things. I will talk about what I'm doing since 1.5 years. So. Yeah, to tell a bit about myself. I'm a geographer by education, but 6 years ago I ended up in the Berlin tech scene. I used to work at VUGA for nearly 5 years, and yeah, in summer 2015 I've decided to take some time off and to do something for society. And what was never meant to become a huge NPO project, yeah, started actually off with a training session teaching refugee ladies how to ride a bike in front of a refugee accommodation in Moabit. 1.5 years later, I'm standing here, and I'm yeah, trying to inspire you guys to improve the world in little steps. So let's kick it off. We describe our project as an education and integration project with low entry barriers, fast visible successes, and a diverse grow opportunity. I've been, yeah, I founded this project with my partner, project partner Annette. I've never met her privately before. We got to know each other on a, the Sticks and Stones conference, where I tried to hire her for VUGA, but she was not willing to have a real employment. But 2 years later, we stood on a training court and yeah, kicked our project off. The goals of our project are mainly, of course, empowerment of female refugees, but of course, CO2 neutral transportation and independence of public transportation things are also relevant goals, to which also drives us to maintain the project. A part of that, there's a lot about exercising and sports, but we also share mutual goals with all the participants, means the volunteers we involve into the project, but also our trainees. And of course, there are a lot of networking opportunities, not only between the helper and the trainees, but also among the different women who are accommodated in Berlin in different refugee shelters, having different newcomer backgrounds, different journeys, and for them, of course, it's also very valuable to share their own experiences. The project is conducted and realized by donations, which means bike donations and also money-wise. And without a huge pool of volunteers, we couldn't do anything, actually. And this is, I would say, they are the most important part of this project. This initiative became a real association last fall. And since winter 2016, we are even accepted as an official nonprofit organization and have this charity status. So, as mentioned earlier, the common goal is getting bikes, girls on bikes. And what you see here is actually a typical setup of our bike trainings. There's a lot about building trust. Imagine you're a woman from an Islamic country maybe, but also from many other countries. We even have trainees from South Europe or the UK. I was surprised to learn how many women do not actually know how to ride a bike. And yeah, this might give you an impression on the very fast visible success stories. If you see this lady on the bike, and 10 minutes later she was able to ride it on her own. We conduct our training sessions currently 3 times a month. There's an open training session conducted near Cottbusser Tor. There's a public traffic school. And apart from that, we offer exclusive trainings directly located at the refugee accommodations, but also offer training sessions on request. The second is very important for us, yeah, to engage and to empower the woman, to trigger them with a bike thing, that they feel comfortable to attend the open training sessions on their own. But we do not only offer the practical training. Of course, it's super relevant, especially here in Berlin, to be a bit familiar with the current traffic rules. So we teach the training also in theory, and currently we offer those theoretical lessons in different languages as Arabic, Kurdish, Farsi, of course, and German and English. And since I don't speak any Arabic, Farsi, nor Kurdish, we of course rely on our volunteers and involve and include our trainees in order to help us with the translations. And that not only applies on the trainings themselves, but also they help us with the social media. They are partly administrators of our Facebook page. And since a few months, we even raised enough money to pay them a little money for their work. That's how it looks like after we have handed over a bike. So every woman who graduated from our training sessions and has showed that she commits somehow to the project, and we can trust that she is educated also with the traffic rules, we hand over an own bike for them. And that not only includes a bike, but also a helmet, a locker, a certificate which proves that she's the legal owner of the bike, because we all know about racial profiling. And if you see someone who would not be supposed being sitting on a bike in Görlitzer Park, maybe, then it's always good to have a proof that the bike is not stolen. That's how the certificates look like. And the picture below is actually an example on also how proud the women look after having received their own bike. But that's not all. Since I really like and enjoy repairing bikes, we started also involving the women into little bike repair workshops. That means we teach them how to repair a puncture, but also get free of any kind of hesitance when it comes to tools and just the approach to help yourself. And the second picture, I think it's a very nice transportation method of seeing how young girls from Afghanistan are super, super busy fixing punctures. So 10 minutes earlier, they destroyed the wheel of the bike in order to fix it and to prove that they are capable to manage this issue. Of course, not everyone is able to show this fast, visible success. I would say on average, the women take 10 to 20 minutes to learn how to ride a bike. But there are, of course, a few cases which are not that successful. And Fatia, of course, it's all, they allowed us to present their pictures. She's joining our trainings more than 1 year. And we found out that she will never be able to ride a bike. So we organized tricycles. And also this little vehicle, I don't know what it's called in English, just to make them a bit more comfortable with the balance issues, and that they at least have something to play around. Funnily, in Arabic speaking, they always say, "I play with a bike," and not "I ride a bike," because it's really attached to being a toy. And when the women get out of their childhood, they don't have anything to do with a bike anymore. That is, I would say, the biggest success from last year. We could empower and engage some graduates from our training to guide a charity run on the Tempelhofer Feld, which was conducted by the Berliner AIDS-Hilfe. And two of those girls had never been able to manage a distance longer than maybe 1 kilometer or so. And they could prove that it's possible to have a 5 or 10K trip on their bike, and of course that makes them super proud. The second success story I'd like to share is the third Hartung Suruci Prize we've been awarded with. Hartung Suruci was a Turkish girl who had been shot on the street in Neukölln because she separated from a boyfriend. And I think it was one of her brothers who killed her on the open street. And the Green Party in Berlin yearly awards some engagement related to feminism with this prize, and this year we have been awarded with that. And you see there's a lot about inclusion. So 50% of the people captured on this image are our graduates and our, the base of our trainees. But more about sharing their own experiences. Huda, the girl on the picture, is a very good example that for the typical client we serve with a project. She learned how to ride a bike, and she's not only using the bike, she feels super committed to our project, and that's a kind of her thank you when she sent us this picture collage in order to show us that it's not only riding the bike when she comes to the trainings, but also that it makes her super proud that she's able to do the bike tours on the Tempelhofer Feld. So far, we've got more than 330 women on a bike and conducted, I think it's 37 bike trainings in the last 1.5 years. We've handed out more than 50 bike sets to our graduates, and I mentioned the prize already. And if you're open to help us in terms of backing up the ladies on the trainings, feel free to approach me later on. I'm always happy for more new faces. And the good thing in volunteer managing is also that they don't have to commit to the project for a very long time. They definitely can prove their input only with attending one training sessions. our next goal is actually growing the project. There are a few associate projects already in Switzerland and in southern Germany. We are super happy to share our experience and also our education material. If someone says, okay, I'd like to found a new group somewhere also in different other countries. We work on train our graduates that at some point they can also manage a whole bike training. And this is of course related to the success of funding applications from the government side, which is always a tricky thing. And all people see that there's a very, it's a very important work, but of course there isn't any money for that. So we still trust on our donators. And I've listed a few. And get in touch with me if you want to learn more about the project. Thank you very much.